Here, I just wanted to share with you, for example, this is now typically when you become quite experienced in trading options, you would end up now trading combinations of options to actually either improve your, especially the sellers of options, because they're exposed to unlimited risk in the event when the option buyers exercise. So many a time they would sell an option but also buy back something else to cover their downside risk, basically. And this can be done through spreads and calendar spreads. And I'll just, for the lack of time, just take one example and just show you what we mean by some of these vertical spreads. Vertical spreads involve the purchase of one option and the sale of a second option of the same type, with the same underlying and the same expiration, but with a different strike prices. Okay. We call them vertical simply because they refer to the prices or the strike prices, one being over the other. So it's just a terminology. It's a limited risk, but also limited reward type of strategy. And it's for some of the conservative traders who wouldn't want to have 100% exposure to the risk, and then they enter the market, but then they take a counter position to cover themselves. We said here we've got bull call spreads, bear call spreads, but let me just take one example of the bull call spreads just to illustrate. Now, what are bull call spreads? It's a purchase of one call and the sale of another call with the same underlying and the same expiration, but higher strike prices. So both calls have the same expiration date and number of options. In other words, if you say you decide to take one or two of 10 lots, then it has to be the same size on both sides. And they are bought in equals to those sold. Yeah, that's what I indicated. So in this case example, we have got 2,600 rand per ton and a 2,680 bull call spread. Why are they called a bull? Positions profit as the underlying prices are bullish. And in that case, that's where the name comes from. They are a bull call because both strategies involve call options. And they are a spread because what is a spread is simply the difference between the strike prices. And that is what we call a spread. Also referred to as a debit call spread. Well, let me leave that to you to ponder why it is called a debit call spread. And here, this is just a printout from a software which just calculated what we had indicated earlier there. It's one long position, one long call at 26 and one short at 26.80. And you can see these are the payoffs of the strategy. Okay. And by the way, if I can answer the question of a debit, the long call, this is the value or the money that the buyer actually had to pay. And for the short call, he received or she received this amount. And the reason why it's called a debit is simply because that the net effect of the two gives you a debit, leaves you with a debit. Some other strategies will leave you with additional cash. So you bought, you expensed to buy, but then when you sold, the income you got is higher than the one you sold. So you have got a little bit of a surplus, and that would then be a credit. And in this case, this is a debit. So these are some of the illustrations that I just wanted to share with you this afternoon. I have so many issues I would have loved to share and to illustrate, but the time is against us. And what we have decided to do is to actually just do frequent presentations where we look at different topics. So I leave what I left out in this one in other presentations. Thank you.